Good morning. Today we are going to study about the next topic, that is it good to have political competition? Here, you know that competition, sometimes it is good, but sometimes it is not good. So same way, political competition or in the politics to win the seats, to get the power, that competition is good or bad. First thing, that the demerits or the drawbacks of this political competition, let us study. First thing is that this political competition, it creates disunity among the people. All people, they differentiate or they divide into different political parties, so which create disunity. And also it creates factionalism. Factionalism means small groupism. That it creates. So first thing is that political competition, it creates disunity and factionalism. Second thing, that political parties, they put some allegations against each other. Allegations against each other in the sense criticisms. They criticize against each other. You can see the opposition party criticize the ruling party. Ruling party criticize the opposition party, or some other parties, among 2-3 parties, they criticize each other. These all create some problem in the country. Instead of development, instead of for the good welfare of the people, it creates some groupism and disunity. So they put forward or they level the allegations, that is a demerit of the political competition. Third thing is that political parties, they bring some dirty tricks to win the power. So in the election, sometimes you can hear, or somewhere you can hear through the paper, media, etc., to win the election, to get the seats, the political parties, they bring some dirty tricks. So this is also one of the important demerit we can number. Fourth thing is that there are many good people, many people actually they wish to come into the politics, but because of this disunity among the people, or because of this politics, too much competition in the political parties, they are not ready to come into this arena. Means many people, they want to serve the country, they want to serve the people, they want actually to work for the welfare of the people, but they are not ready to enter into this politics because of the competition. So these are the important thing or important demerit. Students, you might be thinking that why our constituent assembly members have made this competition, political competition, in our electoral system. Actually, they were knowing these demerits of electoral competition or this political competition, but though these demerits were there, they had opted a political competition for a country like India, because this competition actually works in the long run. So even though this much demerits are there, but it is the competition or the electoral competition is good for the country because it works for the long run. In the sense, when people elect their representative, they work for the betterment of the people. Suppose these elected members don't work for the people, people can judge them. People can make them change, or people can change them. Next election, that party cannot get the power. So it is actually people who make the choice. So to get the choice for the people, competition is good. That is why our constituent assembly members have made this electoral competition in our system. Okay, now next we have to study about what is the system of election in our country. To study it better, very important thing, that how the election is conducted. So to conduct the election in the country, it is not an easy task. A country like India, very vast country, to conduct election, there are mainly Lok Sabha election and another type of election. It is known as Vidhan Sabha elections. Lok Sabha election is for the entire country, means government of the country. So it is the general election or government for the government of the country. Lok Sabha election is made or it is conducted. Vidhan Sabha election in the sense for a particular state, that within that state election is conducted. That is known as Vidhan Sabha election. And the people who are, or the contestants who have who gets maximum vote or who win the election in the Lok Sabha election, they become the member of parliament, or he is known as MP. And the contestant who gets maximum vote or who win the election in the state legislative assembly, he is known as the MLA or member of legislative assembly. So Vidhan Sabha election, those who win, he become the MLA, and those who win in the Lok Sabha election, he or she becomes MP or member of parliament. These few things you have to understand. Next thing, when the country is made for, when the country is preparing for election, entire country is divided into some areas for the purpose of election. Only for the purpose of election, the country is divided into areas. These areas are known as constituencies. So in Lok Sabha election, there are 543 constituencies in our country. For entire country is divided into 543 constituencies. Same way, in Vidhan Sabha election, the state is again divided into different areas. These constituencies for the state election. Same way, we can see municipality or panchayat election also. The panchayat or that municipality is divided into different areas. That areas, here we mentioned for this panchayat or municipality, we use the term that is known as ward. Ward is used for that areas. So there are, these type of system works for the, or it is good for conducting the election smoothly. So in particular constituency, the contestants, the candidates can contest the elections. And so these are the important thing. And constituencies are also known as seats. So constituencies locally, some another name people use that is known as seats. These are the important thing or terms you have to understand. Now we have to study about some of the reserved constituencies. I have told you that constituency means the areas. The country is divided into particular areas for the purpose of conducting election. So these areas are known as constituencies. Our constituent assembly members have even thought about the problems of the weaker section of our country. Weaker section means some of the people, according to the caste system, some people at that time, they were they did not have availability of education, they did not have wealth. So such people had a different problem. That is why some constituencies are reserved for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe people. And in our country, for the Lok Sabha election, scheduled caste people, 84 seats are reserved for scheduled caste constituencies. So constituencies for scheduled caste in our country for the Lok Sabha election is 84 seats are reserved for them. And scheduled tribe, it is 47 seats are reserved for scheduled tribe people. Why it is made? Because in order to put forward their demands, in order to understand, in order to make the government understand their problem, some representatives are needed from their community. So to in these seats of or reserved constituencies, the candidate belonging to the scheduled caste or scheduled tribe, they can contest the election, and they can, through that representative, through that candidate, through that representative, the people can put forward their problems. So for that purpose, to increase the level of, or to bring them up, to bring the status of the weaker section of our society, these system of reserved constituencies are created. So I have told you that these are the number of seats reserved for them. Next thing, in the local level administration like municipality or a panchayat, in some of the states they have made the provision for other backward caste seats are reserved for OBC or other backward caste. And in the local level administration like panchayat and municipality, women also have a reservation of seats. That is, 1/3 seats are reserved for women. So these are the special allotment or special distribution of seats for the weaker section of the society. Weaker section here in the sense scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, other backward community or other backward caste, and women. Women also have in the local level administration 1/3 seats are reserved. So these are the things that you have to remember.